Hey guys! Welcome back to Let's Play Xenosaga Episode 2! Last time, we had some database from Episode 3 and a cutscene in which Albedo dies! What the hell, game? This time, we fight the Patriarch! I was going to do all my stalking ahead of time, however, this is the only time you get this message. Proto-Merkaba is technically a target in this fight, although he doesn't really do anything until the Patriarch himself is low on HP. Most of its attacks are aura-based, hence the aura coat on everyone. He is also 200% weak to Pierce, 175 to Slash, 150 to Hit, weak to Physical. He takes reduced damage from Beam, Thunder, Fire, and Ice. Hence why Chaos is in here, he takes 100% normal damage from Aura. So we're going to do a nice Aura chain here and have some fun.
I shall show you the way.
Okay, so you can stalk as well. Every other of Proto-Omega's turns, he'll just sit there and do nothing. He'll sit on his ass. I can move in this fight. I didn't even realize that. Okay, I'm going to do that too. Okay, first things first. This is the last time we're probably going to have to steal... Well, this is the last time we have to steal one of these. And I alluded to this before. Not helping. I said I was alluding to this before. Give me the item I want. Awakening 4. This boss, once you reload your save data, after you've beaten the game, you can load complete file, you can come and kill the final boss again. Over and over and over again, cycle, 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 and that's how you would get all of the Awakening manuals to sell in order to get all the money to pay off the that one GS campaign that I paid off way earlier in the game. But think about it. We wouldn't have swimsuits for Jin, even now. Really. Like, I'm not using them in this fight, and I didn't use them in the last fight, but that's about it. Alright, next thing. Attacker! We also need to set up Boost 1. So you can go with Attacker as well. And you might as well set up Boost 1. And let's see here. So we got Attacker. Now we want to set up Aura Sword. Now, my parties for the last fight and this one were basically to use everyone except for Xion. So it's not necessarily the best party. It probably would be better to bring in Momo than it would be to have, maybe Chaos or Jin. He's weakest to Pierce, but he's also weak to Physical, hence why all Physical-based people in this fight. So you need Aura Sword as well. This boss is rather annoying. He can use Curse on you, which is annoying. He can use Boost Lock on you, which is very annoying. And he can cast Quick on himself. We do have a way around that now, and this is why I learned this ability, Annihilation. It's non-elemental attack, damage doesn't matter, but it clears status effects. So very useful in that sense. You don't need to set that up. Do I need Attacker on you yet? I do need Attacker on you yet. So let's do that. Before you start unloading combos on this guy, probably a good idea. Well, you know what? Because it's your turn, you can move back there. Just don't turn around. Perfect. So we're going to boost you. So your break zone is BCBB. And then we're going to boost you, and BB, and we're going to down the crap out of you. Now, you can air this guy as well, but then Chaos couldn't hit him, so not going to really do that. So let's boost Chaos. There we go. And then we will boost you. Well, it's not like I can cancel your turn, but this is your final boss. Now, pay attention to the victory screen once we hit it here, which we will in a moment. Watch the screen. Look at the characters in there and the time and the experience. It's a rather cool idea. Everyone's level 99.
To the likes of you.
The battle took 13 seconds. Isn't that cool? I just think that's awesome. That's so cool. Anyway, this guy, of course, because he's the final boss, he has two forms. He has more HP in this form. He's more annoying in this form.
Fool.
Stock again. This time, before we start our chain, our boost chain, we're going to want to heal because he can do some decent damage. Considering he's the final boss, he should damn well better be able to. But we got a set boost. I don't need boost one, do I? Cool. I need stock one on you. Now, once he gets low on HP, he'll also start casting Quick. You can use Annihilation to remove it, but at the same time, he's kind of annoying and he'll just recast it over and over and over and over again. And he likes to use his boosts now. I think he could do this before, but he likes to do it a lot more now. This is one of the reasons why you want to make sure you're healed up before you start your whole chain here. Yeah, we'll just go with Medic All there. And then you can go with Medica 2 on you, and we'll be all set up and ready to go. I kind of wanted you to face the other way, but okay, I can do it this way too. Now that he's in another form, he's changed his break zone, so it's now BCC. And so we're going to boost you and CC and get you down. Plus, we're going to cancel his turn.
Sorry.
And then we're going to boost you. And I think I'm just going to unload your entire stock there. I think that's a good idea. See, all of his attacks when the enemy is downed are hit. So unfortunately, he's not going to do as much damage.
Eat this.
So let's go with three attacks there, because I think that should fill up my stock most of the way, or my boost most of the way. And then we're going to boost you, attack you, and then we're going to boost you, and then we'll boost you right over again. So one hit this time, and then one hit that time. With two hits that time. Of course, by now, my all of my buffs have worn off. So next thing's stock. Everybody wants to stock. He's going to cast Quick. He's annoying with Quick. Now, once he starts doing that, he'll start attacking you pretty fast. So your go-to way to cancel it, of course, is Annihilation. But he's going to probably, he might even boost himself so he can recast that. Or he'll just wait for his next turn. Either way, he loves to cast that over and over and over again.
Fall before the might of Proto Omega.
He can also, I think that might actually have been the cue. Once he reaches low enough HP, he will actually make use of Proto Merkaba.
Time to deal with the
this isn't it. And it will do a beam attack that will do a lot of damage, like 1,000 damage or 700 damage or something like that. Since Merkaba is boosting now, there it is. So a couple of people have guarded. Hopefully that's enough to alleviate some of this. Unfortunately, Jin,
I'm sorry, I couldn't.
Not so much. And he's going to cast Quick again. See, this is probably the only difficult part of this fight. Do I have something that revives more than one person? I do not. Yeah, I want to save those for later.
Here.
Good thing I have boosts, because I need to revive some peoples. And then we'll revert on you. I could have used revert both times, but I'd be low on EP if I did that.
Time to deal with the likes of you.
Now, hopefully, he can do up to, like, 500 damage with a lot of these attacks, so I want to get Medica All going really fast. So hopefully this doesn't kill anybody. Fool. Of course, if he boosts 6,000 times, yeah, he's gonna die.
Those who oppose me never return alive.
Ow. Yeah, this will inflict curse. Now, what curse does is every time we do damage to him, it will be bounced back onto Jin now. So first things first, heal. And you can heal as well. I can just avoid using Jin now. That's fine. Basically, spam heal all so that we can stay alive. It's actually one of the more difficult fights in the game, but you can reduce a lot of his HP really fast. Let's go Medica 2 on you there. Now, I also need boosts. Would be very, very nice. Either that, or I need to get Chaos's turn on the right one. So I want to get, where is it? Aura Sword on you. And here, I want to set up boost one. And then I'm going to boost, oh, who is it? There we go, Chaos. And Chaos is going to set up BC, and then I will boost you. And you can go CC, and then I can unload. Hopefully that will be enough. It may or may not be, I'm not sure. It was not quite enough. Oh well. Yeah, you got a little more left. That's fine. No big deal. I can set that up easily again. So yeah, I want to set up stock one on you. And you are going to set up boost one. And boost you. Pretty much the same thing all over again. And boost you, so BC. And there we go. And that's your final boss. Tell me you get times 10. I get times 4, I'll take it. This time, the ending screen is actually worthwhile. It's not a fake one, but it does take quite some time to finish this fight. And we get a lot of skill points from this. Very nice. It's a good way of grinding if you want to run through the final boss gauntlet over and over again, but that's up to you.
Why do you stand before me like this? What good is any of this going to do you?
How the hell should we know? You're the one who's doing all this. You're the enemy.
I don't have time for this nonsense. Once you see this, your babbling mouths will be silenced for good. A UMN phase transfer cannon, a weapon that can strike any target from anywhere in space.
Why, you?
Basically, you using the UMN to hit anywhere.
I'll send you to meet him soon. When you reach the afterlife, be sure and tell Helma too.
Well, yeah, that sounds about right. This is a Xenosaga game. We're dead.
What's going on? What's wrong? Work! Come on, work!
Makes me think
the
of Cyan.
Does not exist for your sake.
Not very good with the machine, Cyan is. Maybe Sergius is like that too. Or maybe we have testaments.
Who's there? We'd appreciate it if the supporting actors could just stick to their roles.
Considering that's what you guys have been the entire game.
Testament.
And series. Are you going to take
the stage? Your act is over.
A more direct role now. What?
No. I am all power.
That's what defeated Albedo. And it's gone. What the fuck?
What is it?
See someone you know?
That's why I showed you that image before. Because otherwise the scene makes no sense. They give you a brief idea, and that's it.
You! Voyager!
Oh, shit. I want their powers.
Play around. Begin.
Look who's back!
This is not what you were born to do!
I don't know how he knows what's going on already, but, basically, the Testaments revive Albedo here.
Au contraire! This is the very moment I've been waiting for! Come, Rubido. Come to my world. Let's have some fun.
You may notice the Udu-colored light around him. Yeah, he's kind of mixing with the Udu waveform at this point. Love this music.
KOS-MOS?
Xion, under the current conditions, I can hold this for approximately 3 minutes. Please escape immediately.
KOS-MOS?
This is reminding me of the end
but
of the first
how?
Game.
The Elsa is currently heading towards our present coordinates.
Definitely.
If you destroy the exterior wall, you should be able to rendezvous with it.
Destroy the wall?
That'd be his job, if he can get up.
Leave it to me.
Ziggy, you shouldn't be moving in your condition.
Don't worry.
His right hand is gloved. His left hand is bare. I'm not sure if that has any reasoning why he uses his left hand here. He may be left-handed, I'm not sure. It's actually the first time that I even clued into it. Maybe the only scene where it even makes sense, but it doesn't matter. At this point, he is right-handed because he only has one arm. That's what we like to see.
Hurry,
escape
Chief.
Route.
Please get on board. We're almost out of time.
Instead of doing the escape sequence like they did in episode 1, they just say, oh, we have to escape, and then we escape.
At long last, my time has come. The time to join the eternal chain. The time to quench my thirst at the source.
Well, that's interesting. And with that being said, that's our final boss.
No change in the waves from the space-time anomaly. Further expansion appears to be temporarily halted.
Well, it sounds like we owe one to KOS-MOS.
Again.
We don't have time to relax, little master. The phenomena alteration may have stopped expanding for now, but it's just a matter of time before it starts up again.
It'll swallow up the whole region eventually, won't it? Isn't there any way to stop it?
It's likely the only way to resolve this situation is to go in there and destroy the source directly. But the risk involved is enormous.
How are the Elsa and the assault craft?
Smart, Junior.
They have sustained a great deal of damage, but they are still operational.
We gotta do it somehow.
Okay, got it. Shelly, I need you to take over here.
Acknowledged.
She seems to be doing that quite well. And with that, we gain control of Junior on his own. This literally is the end. As far as skills go, no, that's the one. There we go. You know, probably need anything else. I don't think I need that. Let's throw that on. Yeah, that's probably fine. Doesn't really matter what you have on. You put on pretty much anything you want. Combo boost is good, of course. Status double isn't really helpful at this point, but let's talk to Kanan. What do you have to say? Now, that just makes me sad. The lack of interaction with the NPCs. I've been playing another game, and I've just been raving, you know, to anyone who will listen about the really good NPCs, and English aside. But the NPCs are interesting because our characters actually interact with them. They don't do that in this game. If you go over here, where would you like to go? Well, you only have two options. We can't do anything if we go to the dock area, so we gotta go to the park area. Which, it's not really apparent what we're supposed to do at this point, so it's kind of weird. Anyway, give me one sec to double check something really quick, and then I will see you in a quick moment. Okay, so I just wanted to go and see how many cutscenes there were and how long it was going to take. Definitely not something I can do quickly today and get me to another point, so we'll have to stop here. I also went to double check my guide, and I'm going to go with these as my equipment. Count combo boost as always, revenge power, ice coat, boss or the... Basically, there's one final quote-unquote boss, but we will take a look at that when we get to it. There is some more to do in the game, but basically, it's time for the final. That's all for this one, and I'll see you guys next time.